unsure between healthy and sick. If you're pregnant or think you are, getting prenatal care early is the most important step you can take. Don't put your baby's health on the line. Take care of yourself so you can take care of your baby. Find out now about getting prenatal care. Call 1-800-311-2229.
On January 8th, Amy Narvejo was saved from freezing to death by the National Guard. Were it not for their employers giving them the time to answer the call, this story might have had a different ending. To every employer who supports the Guard and Reserve, thanks for making us your business.
It's not a national emergency, it's a neighborhood fire. Yet for the families who lost their homes, it's a major disaster.
What does the Red Cross do in a situation like this?
We're here to help the families. We give them food and blankets, and we provide shelter.
I was with the families last night, and thank goodness they didn't lose their lives. But in so many ways, they did. When people think of the Red Cross, they think of hurricanes and blood drives, but there's so much more.
The Red Cross is always involved in the community. It's neighbor helping neighbor.
Who pays for all of this to happen?
We help people, people help us.
First to respond with care and relief. Count on the Red Cross to be there for your family. But we're not a government agency. We rely on you. Call the Red Cross because your help can't wait.
That's why folks call it finger hammer. That
sounds good.
Yeah, we've got a lot of crazy stuff happening today. A lot of unexpected shite, as it were. Welcome to the third episode of BS, and with me, as always, is my crow host.
Oh, yeah.
The crow.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah. I'm the crow host, and yet.
Yep, as usual, crow is the crow host.
I sure am. You know, I'm just, like, chilling and, like, being crow host.
Of course. Crow has to be a crow host because crow's a crow host.
Oh,
man,
yeah.
I better shut up.
Yeah, right.
Oh, boy. Let me tell you, man. There is a lot of crap that is, like, floating around, and it just, like, likes to float and stuff.
Yo, this is bad.
It really is. It's like.
Well, why don't we talk about the other night?
Ah, yes, the other night. See, the other night, we our feedback that we got was not as good as what we said we got last week. Last night, you see.
Sledge.
And I'm getting the signal that my mic is gone. How do I turn this thing?
Hit me. Hit off
is
me.
Is it, well, it, oh.
I had it on mute. Now that is BS. If ever I heard it, I just introduced the show with the damn microphone on mute. Reminds me of the time on Shockwave where like I started the show without a microphone. That was hilarious.
Oh yeah.
I'm sure you guys could have heard me through crows or microphone.
I hope so.
I should hope so. I should hope so. I hope it wasn't just like, and then crow going.
Might as well start the movie. Might as well start the show again.
Might as well. Okay, let's start out how we're going to start it. Guys, we're supposed to know that? Okay, awesome. All right, welcome to the third episode of BS. I'm surprised it's lasted this long.
That hurts.
Shut up. Well, anyway, despite all the naysayers out there, and I just like to address this one thing. This show is what the title says it is. It is BS. So if you get any other like opinion of it, you get any other impression of it, it doesn't matter. It's a BS show. Ow. That's why it's called BS. At least this time it ain't got no thing called hammer time floating in the corner.
Oh, God. Oh.
I never got my choice here.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You're supposed to get your triceratops. Yeah. Or something like that. I don't know.
I don't even know.
Anyways, last night I took a look at my mail, all right? I checked up on the Prism, the Sledgecore message board at sledgecore.cjb.net. Leave a damn message, please. So basically, I checked them. I wrote them down in my notebook, and they weren't as good as last week's messages were. Last week's messages were, hey guys, nice show, it's unique. Of course, Crower didn't get anything, damn you.
Except for that one guy who's like, unable to load picture.
I don't know what that's about.
Yeah, I just got these brackets, it's unable to load picture. What kind of a picture are we gonna send Crow? Would it be porn? Huh? Because why don't you send me the porn? Instead of getting all this crap about, oh, good show, you guys are innovative, send me porn! Anyway.
Stay rich.
Okay, well, put it short, our mail wasn't as positive as we would have liked it to be. So if we could roll the footage of that, that'd be great. Ah, there's our beautiful warden. Show wasn't received as like good as our first show.
Kind of was expecting that.
What?
Kind of was expecting that. Wasn't that great?
That hurt, bro. That hurt.
Sorry.
That hurt.
Being a little honest.
Well, it just wasn't as positive as last week's, and I think you should take a listen to this.
Okay. God.
First off, we got this guy. What? You talking about, I mean, I keep in mind W-A-T. This is W-A-T. That's how we spelled it.
That's something else. And of course, he says you with a U, an actual U. And what you talking about? Viscera is duh next Andre. Jesus Christ, I'm surprised he spelled Andre right.
Yeah.
Austin 316, yo.
It's pretty bad.
Kind of retarded if you ask me.
To say so.
Okay, next one says, the intro was good. Too bad the show didn't back it up. I had more fun that time I got a razor blade stuck in my eye.
That hurts.
I'm sure it does. Damn, our show must hurt to watch. Oh boy, this was my favorite quote. This one is my absolute favorite. Just listen to this one.
Okay.
Just writing to let you know that I was on the toilet when your show came on and nothing came out. That, I'm hurt. I believe that your show is so much like some crap that it somehow stopped me from doing the same thing. I hope you rot in hell.
That's
kind of stupid. I mean, I didn't think it would cause anybody constipation, maybe a headache. I don't know.
That's mean. That's real mean.
That's just no unwarranted. There's no need for that. Your show is a bunch of bullshit. Incur, get this. He says, Britney sucks.
Oh, man. That's somehow.
You know what? I don't think we can do this anymore.
I don't think so either.
Hey, guys, Bark of the Moon is on.
Really? Cool! Oh, crap, cool! Awesome, thanks, man!
That would have been the intro. See, the way we were planning is, well, it was like going from the warning to that, to the intro, but things didn't work out quite. But you know what? It's public access. Who cares?
Yeah. It's no big deal.
Yeah, really. Not like anybody's going to remember anyway.
But Mark of the Moon was awesome.
Oh, boy.
Oh, jeez.
1-inch man equals Park.
That's messed up. Anyways,
PTM pilot.
Yes, if you can, get a copy of the pilot. In fact, I think I know someone who does have a copy of it that can, like, distribute it. Eh? You were pretty good with saying it, like, on the first show when you didn't have a mic. About, like, getting people, if they want to get the pilot, what do they have to do? Who do they have to email?
The Sledge?
Well, try it without your hand covered this time. So you hear
all right, I guess you can email bsshow at fatchicksandpartyhats.com because you know the party ain't started till there's some fat chicks wearing some party hats. Someone did put a hat on some ham. Yes, a party hat. Okay. Well, today,
and you can email me like an actual picture this time.
Yeah, really. And give me some porn, please.
Some smut would be greatly appreciated for both the Sledge and the Crow.
Damn right.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Well, our topic today is fast food urban legends. We've got a couple, we found a bunch of them in like very various sources. You know, it's amazing the kind of things people will believe.
Fast food urban legends?
Fast food urban legends.
Christ.
I haven't even gotten into it yet.
just talk.
All right.
Stop that. Gross.
Damn it. Executive producer of this thing yet. I'm taking orders from like somebody else.
Oh.
Please don't hurt me, please. Really.
Somebody broke somebody down.
I'm sorry. Oh my God. All right, well, anyways. The first story of tonight is a woman, in fact, ordered a chicken sandwich without any mayo. All right, she bites into it. She tastes this saucy thing. All right? Of course, she asked for no mayo, so she brings it up to the counter, and she says, hey, I wanted this without mayo. The cashier said, yes, I put it in without mayo. And then she's like, well, what the hell is this? They investigate it. According to the legend, it was a tumor, and the sauce was pus from that tumor. That's what they say.
Did now, she mention how it tasted? How it tasted?
No, they didn't mention how it tasted. They didn't mention that. But one thing, there are a couple, like, interesting things about this.
One thing, it's a chicken sandwich, and it's probably at KFC or McDonald's or something that they mean it to take place. And basically, and another interesting thing, it's usually a woman who eats it, as if trying to sell some sort of sexist story.
That's mean.
That is mean, Crow. That is mean. We are living in a world of equality, and that kind of bullcrap should stop.
That is, I guess, real mean.
Well,
so was it true?
No, it wasn't true.
Okay.
See, here's the facts. A tumor is a cancerous mass, a hard cancerous mass, all right? It doesn't have pus. If it was a cyst, maybe. But a tumor, no. And even if it was a cyst, let's say this person said it wrong, it would never survive the frying process. Anything that would have been there would have been blown up in the fryer, all right? And also, when they've noticed it when they were putting the fixins on, huh? They process those things just so, like, you could put the fixins on easily, all right?
They were fixins, the fixins!
I guess so.
Or something.
Yeah, I guess.
But so what? It's not true.
All right.
It's just a rumor.
That's true. That's true. But it's just interesting to hear. You know? It's just, don't start with the problem.
It's not a fact.
All right. Another one is like saying that like fast food companies like McDonald's or Burger King are using, get this, worm meat instead of actual hamburger meat. In fact, really? I've also heard like McDonald's is the world's largest purchaser of cow eyeballs. Okay, let's get this straight, all right? To gather up worm meat will cost a hell of a lot more. I'd say like, I don't know, probably about like $6 a pound or something. I don't know. Whatever it is, it's a hell of a lot more than actually getting cow meat. And now let's not even get into
how the hell do you know how much worm meat costs, man?
I agree.
How the hell do you know that?
I ain't even gonna get into the cow eyeballs.
Oh, you read it somewhere, right? You read it somewhere?
Yes, Johnny, I read it somewhere.
Okay. All right.
I don't make this up, all right? I didn't make it up.
All right. Can I make a statement?
Yes, girl.
I don't understand. I was reading that too. And there's one thing that, you know, kind of was funny. Mm-hmm. It's like it said McDonald's is the top seller in, what was it, cow eyeballs?
Yeah.
And it's like, or what, was Burger King second? I mean.
Yeah, who else buys cow eyeballs? You know, eyeball.
I didn't know that was such a popular.
Sledge!
I didn't know that was such a popular. Yeah, he got it up there with the worm meat.
Yeah, with the worm meat.
You're disgusting.
I didn't say I liked it. But all right. For one thing, let's just throw away this whole cow eyeball thing. Here's how we throw this away with fact. Okay, it would cost a hell of a lot less just to use the regular beef from a cow. Instead of just plucking out two eyeballs and mashing it together.
Agreed.
Yeah, because, like, I mean, you got a hell of a lot more beef in the cow than you got meat in the eyeballs.
Correct.
Yeah. It just doesn't make any sense.
So correct. You're trying to say that the second one you just said is a rumor?
The second one I said it was a rumor? And here's what's going to dismiss the first one. Here's what's going to dismiss the first one. You know how much worms are going to have to dig up to make that many hamburgers?
Hell yeah.
That's the reason why it's so expensive. Not because I know it personally.
Why you're assuming? You're making an educated guess?
Yes, perhaps? I guess so.
But these aren't facts. I mean, well, these things you're saying aren't facts.
They are not facts.
If you dissected a worm in high school, man, you'd know that it's just mostly. It makes sense what you're saying.
Oh, wake up, girl. Wake up.
Sorry, I fell asleep or something.
Really?
All right.
Somebody's going to find a bomb in their car.
Here's a. Good thing I don't have a car.
Me either.
Oh, yeah, I'm beat.
Okay.
Well, after tonight.
Someone's being evil.
Yeah, someone's being real evil.
Someone should be like on the camera and like have this negative.
Shut up.
Okay. Okay. Here's another popular rumor that I heard.
Oh yeah,
man, like BATM pilot.
Effect or something.
Yep. Excellent.
We should just kill
Let's just show that.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So everyone can know what the hell we're talking about.
I don't think so. Anyways, let's get to something that they might know what we're talking about. Okay, there's this rumor that this girl had a soft chicken taco, all right, and there was a roach in it. And we were all still for a second.
Not that kind of roach, Johnny. Not that kind of roach.
Oh.
But apparently, this thing managed to escape the vicious molars and, like, managed to lay some eggs in her salivary glands, and those and it hatched, and, like, she had to go to the doctor, and they found out, and it was pretty disgusting. Huh. Wrong! First of all, it would be magic that she totally missed the roach, all right? And then finally crunch on it. And wouldn't she notice any crunching? I mean, lettuce is crispy, but it's not that crunchy.
It doesn't go...
Yeah, really. Besides, there's no black ingredients in a soft chicken taco. It's just chicken, lettuce, and cheese. That's it.
Are you going to prove any of these? Like, are any of these true? I mean, like, are you going
to... Just shut up, Crow! All right? I'll get to it. You're getting on my nerves.
Okay, whatever, man. I'm just... It's, like, dumb. We're, like, talking about rumors. But let's not talk about...
It's fun to realize how stupid some people are. That's what I liked about the whole Brother Walt experience, is I have so many stupid callers, and Brother Walt's just like, you don't know what you're talking about. Shut up.
Oh, yeah.
That was fun. That was hilarious. But anyway, you got it. Okay, let's not get back to table talk now. Okay. Well, okay. For one thing, roaches, if they laid an egg in the salivary glands, the saliva is coming out of the salivary glands, and Crow is just forever coming out of his seat. It's always coming out of the salivary glands. It's flowing outward, so there's no way the roach eggs get pushed inwards. Okay, now that's a bunch of BS right there. And I am the Crow.
That's... No, you're not! You're not the Crow, okay?
The sign says...
It's the Crow!
Sludge is the new effing Crow.
No, pretty much.
Oh, man. I wish my arms were falling.
Okay, now here's a popular one about, like... This is probably due to a lot of people's xenophobia. Now... What's the deal with the pointing?
The crow belongs over there.
Oh, okay. Well, I don't even know what you're talking about. But anyways, this probably has to deal with a lot of people's xenophobia about, like, foreign cultures and, like, cultures that are different to them. I think we've all heard the nasty rumors about Chinese restaurants serving up cat, all right, and dog, and whatever miscellaneous animal you may mention. I mean, granted, there are some, they do... Some people do eat that. I mean, I'm not saying it's an outright lie. Some people do eat that.
It's about time.
But here's the thing.
And the butts.
There
this
is
big.
No way that they would sell it in America. There's no way they would sell it here in America. And besides, not that many people do that. Not that many people do that. I mean, it's just like something to scare people, and it's been starting since the 1800s. It's just a poor xenophobic thing. All right. So get that out of your head. Get that out of your head.
Why? Bro. I'm so sick of you with these. It's like, could you at least bring up some facts?
Crow, I'm getting to it, okay? I'm getting to something.
Are you gonna dance tonight?
I mean, you're going to bring up some facts? I mean, facts would be helpful.
I guess.
People want to hear, like, horror stories are real.
Okay, now, a lot of people have wondered about, like, the, like, when KFC changed their name. And what happened was, it was Kentucky Fried Chicken, then all of a sudden they shortened it to KFC. All right? Now, and, Crow, I have a feeling that...
You're just ridiculous tonight.
Well, fine, you don't want me to do this urban legend thing? What is so wrong with urban legends?
You know what?
I mean, I don't know, I'm not in the mood for it.
Excuse me, what's up?
What are you doing?
Who's that?
That's Chaparita Asari.
Who?
Chaparita Asari.
Well, you know what I think she is?
Oh.
No! No!
That was mean. That was really mean. I'm sorry, Sledge, that happened.
No! 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 Oh, my God.
Okay, get over
let's,
it.
Let's
just get over it.
I guess I have to.
Okay, just get over it.
Okay, now... I don't... Crow.
What?
What is your reason for doing this?
I don't know.
Why do you gotta bitch so much about this?
I don't know, I just wanna hear facts, okay? I just wanna hear facts. Just wanna hear facts. I don't know what your big problem is with, like, facts. I mean, this is ridiculous. Just get on with it. Like... Stop with these damn rumors and talk about some facts. Do you have any news about facts? Like, do you have any, like, restaurant horrors that are real?
I mean, come on. What's wrong with you? What's wrong with you? Oh, boy. Okay. Well, that, my friends, is my whole thing on urban legends, fast food urban legends, okay?
Yeah. God, freaking idiot. You have to do
that now. I can't believe you, Crow. I can't believe you. I cannot believe you, Crow, that you are not listening to what I am saying.
You're kind of not listening to what anybody's saying.
All right, fine. I guess I have to do this to disprove you. What are you doing? What are you doing? You'll see. You POS!
Oh, yeah.
You know I can't. You know when the song comes on?
What's the matter with him? I sure do.
Jam!
What the hell is he doing? He's jamming.
I can't believe this. I can't believe you're doing this to me.
Looks like somebody
can't stop jamming.
That'll teach you, girl. That'll teach you.
You're so mean.
Damn right.
Music stop ever.
Why don't you do the downstairs jam?
Make me do the downstairs jam. About to go downstairs. Time to go up an elevator.
On, wax off.
Get some exercise.